बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू विल बी फाइन एंड यू आर इंजॉइंग दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू मैथमेटिक्स इन विच वी हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट नंबर 1 विच इज़ नेम्ड एज मैट्रिसेस एंड डिटर्मिनेंट्स। यू नो दैट मैट्रिक्स इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ कलेक्शन ऑफ रियल नंबर्स विच आर इनक्लोज्ड इन ब्रैकेट्स। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू मैट्रिसेस आर मल्टीप्लाइड। Firstly, we will discuss the process for multiplication of matrices. If we have any two matrices like matrix A and matrix B, then these matrices can be multiplied if the number of columns of matrix A is equal to number of rows of matrix B. Then we can say that matrix A and matrix B are comfortable for each other. For example, we have two matrices, matrix A with the elements 1, 2, 3, 0, and matrix B with the elements 4 and 1. Then first of all we will check the number of columns in matrix A. As you can see that matrix A has 2 columns and matrix B has 2 rows. So number of columns of matrix A is equal to number of rows of matrix B. So we can multiply these matrices. For this we can write AB equal to elements of the matrix A into elements of the matrix B. First of all, first row of matrix A is multiplied with the first column of matrix B, and then these elements are added. For this we can write 1 multiply 4 plus 2 multiply 1. And then second row of matrix A is multiplied with the first column of matrix B, which will give us 3 multiply 4 plus 0 multiply 1. By solving this matrix, we can write 4 plus 2, and in the second row we can write 12 plus 0, which will give us the matrix which has the elements 6 and 12. In this way we can multiply any two matrices. Now we have to solve exercise 1.4. In the first question, you have to tell that which of the given matrices are comfortable for multiplication. And you know that if we have two matrices and if the number of columns of first matrix is equal to number of rows of second matrix, then you can say that these matrices are comfortable for multiplication. So you can do this question by yourself. Now we will solve question number 2, which has two matrices, matrix A with the elements 3, 0, minus 1 and 2, and matrix B with the elements 6 and 5. Now we have to check that number of columns of matrix A must be equal to number of rows of matrix B. And you can see that here are 2 columns in matrix A and 2 rows in matrix B. So these matrices can be multiplied. For this we can write AB equal to elements of the matrix A into elements of the matrix B. Here firstly, first row of matrix A is multiplied with the first column of matrix B. For this we can write 3 multiply 6 plus 0 multiply 5. After this, second row of matrix A is multiplied with the first column of matrix B, which will give us the terms minus 1 multiply 6 plus 2 multiply 5. By solving this matrix, we can write the next matrix as 18 plus 0 and minus 6 plus 10, which is equal to the matrix which has elements 18 and 4. This is the required product for the given matrices A and B. In question number 3, we have to find the following products. In this question, two matrices are given. First is row matrix and second is column matrix. You can see that here is only one row in the first matrix, that's why it is called row matrix. And in the second matrix, here is only one column, so it is called a column matrix. Now we have to check that number of columns of first matrix must be equal to number of rows of second matrix. And you can see that here are two columns in the first matrix and here are also two rows in the second matrix. So these matrices can be multiplied. For multiplication, first row of first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix. It can be written as 1 multiply 4 plus 2 multiply 0. And by simplification, we can get the next matrix which has the term 4 plus 0, which is equal to the matrix which has only one element 4. In this way, we can find the product of any two matrices. In this question, two matrices are given, which are to be multiplied. First of all, we will check that number of columns of first matrix is equal to number of rows of second matrix. And you can see that here are two columns in the first matrix and two rows in the second matrix. So these matrices can be multiplied. For this, we will write first matrix into second matrix. Here, first row of the first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix. For this, we can write 1 multiply 4 plus 2 multiply 0. Then, first row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix. For this, we can write 1 multiply 5 plus 2 multiply minus 4. And then, second row of first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix. For this, we can write minus 3 multiply 4 plus 0 multiply 0. And then, second row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix. For this, we can write minus 3 multiply 5 plus 0 multiply minus 4. And then, third row of first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix, which will give us 6 multiply 4 plus 1 multiply 0. And in the last, third row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix, which will give us the term 6 multiply 5 plus 1 multiply minus 4. By solving these terms in this matrix, we get the next matrix with the terms 4 plus 0, 5 minus 8, minus 12 plus 0, minus 15 plus 0, 24 plus 0 and 30 plus 4. By solving this matrix, we get the next matrix which has the elements 4 minus 3, minus 12 minus 15, 24 and 34, which is the required product for the given matrices. In this question, we have to multiply the 2 by 2 matrices. It means that both these matrices had 2 rows and 2 columns. So these matrices can be multiplied. For this, we will write first matrix into second matrix. Now, first row of the first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix. For this, we can write 8 multiply 2 plus 5 multiply minus 4. Now, first row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix. For this, we can write 8 multiply minus 5 by 2 plus 5 multiply 4. Now, second row of first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix, which can be written as 6 multiply 2 plus 4 multiply minus 4. And in the last, second row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix, which can be written as 6 multiply minus 5 by 2 plus 4 multiply 4. By solving this matrix can be written with the terms 16 minus 20, minus 40 by 2 plus 20, 12 minus 16, and minus 30 by 2 plus 16. In the first column, the terms are subtracted, and in the second column, we will take the LCM of these terms, which can be written as minus 4 minus 4 in the first column, and in the second column, by taking the LCM, we get the terms minus 40 plus 40 over 2, and the last term is minus 30 plus 32 over 2. By solving these terms, we can write minus 4 minus 4 in the first column and 0 by 2 and 2 by 2 in the second column, which is equal to the matrix with elements minus 4 minus 4 as the first column and 0 1 as the second column. Next is question number 5, which has 3 matrices. Matrix A with the elements minus 1, 3, 2 and 0. Matrix B with the terms 1, 2, minus 3 and minus 5. And matrix C with the terms 2, 1, 1 and 3. We have to verify that A into BC is equal to AB into C. First of all, we will take left hand side and we will prove that left hand side is equal to right hand side. By taking left hand side, we can write A into BC is equal to elements of the matrix A, and then elements of the matrix B and C are written in parentheses. So first of all, matrices B and C are multiplied firstly, In the next step, we write matrix A as it is. And when we multiply matrix B and C, first of all, first row of the matrix B is multiplied with the first column of matrix C. For this, we can write 1 multiply 2 plus 2 multiply 1. After this, first row of matrix B is multiplied with the second column of matrix C, which will give us the term 1 multiply 1 plus 2 multiply 3. And then second row of matrix B is multiplied with the first column of matrix C, which will give us the term minus 3 multiply 2 plus minus 5 multiply 1. And in the last, second row of matrix B is multiplied with the second column of matrix C, which will give us the term minus 3 multiply 1 plus minus 3 multiply 5. By solving these terms in the second matrix, we can write the next matrix as matrix A is written as it is, and matrix B with the terms 2 plus 2, 1 plus 6, minus 6 minus 5, and minus 3 minus 15. By solving the terms in the second matrix, we get the next matrix with the terms 4, 7, minus 11, and minus 18. Here, both these matrices are multiplied again. First row of first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix, which will give us the terms minus 1 multiply 4 plus 3 multiply minus 11. Similarly, first row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix, which can be written as minus 1 multiply 7 plus 3 multiply minus 18. And next, second row of first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix, which can be written as 2 multiply 4 plus 0 multiply minus 11. And in the last, second row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix, which can be written as 2 multiply 7 plus 0 multiply minus 18. By solving all these terms in this matrix, we can get the terms in the next matrix as minus 4 minus 33, minus 7 minus 54, 8 minus 0, and 14 minus 0. By solving this matrix, we will get the required matrix, which has the elements minus 37, minus 61, 8, and 14. Now we will prove right hand side, which is equal to AB into C. Here, elements of the matrices A and B are written in parentheses. So both these matrices are multiplied firstly. When we multiply both these matrices, first row of the matrix A is multiplied with the first column of matrix B, which will give us the terms minus 1 multiply 1 plus 3 multiply minus 3. And when we multiply the first row of the matrix A with the second column of matrix B, it will give us the terms minus 1 multiply 2 plus 3 multiply minus 5. In the same way, when second row of the first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix, it will give us the terms 2 multiply 1 plus 0 multiply minus 3. And in the last, when second row of matrix A is multiplied with the second column of matrix B, it will give us the terms 2 multiply 2 plus 0 multiply 5. And in the last, we will write the matrix C as it is. By solving the first matrix, we can write the terms minus 1 minus 9, minus 2 minus 15, 2 minus 0, and 4 minus 0. In this statement, matrix C is written as it is, and by solving the first matrix, we get the required terms in the next matrix as minus 10, minus 17, 2 and 4, which is multiplied by the matrix C. Now by multiplication of both these matrices, when first row of the first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix, it will give us the terms minus 10 multiply 2 plus minus 17 multiply 1. And when first row of first matrix is multiplied with the second column of second matrix, it will give us the terms minus 10 multiply 1 plus minus 17 multiply 3. In the same way, when second row of first matrix is multiplied with the first column of second matrix, it will give us the terms 2 multiply 2 plus 4 multiply 1. And by multiplying the second row of first matrix with the second column of second matrix, we can write 2 multiply 1 plus 4 multiply 3. By solving these terms, we can write the next matrix which has the terms -20 -17 -10 -51 4 plus 4 and 2 plus 12, which will give us the matrix which has the elements -37 -61 8 and 14. Here you can observe that left hand side equal to right hand side, or we can say that A into BC is equal to AB into C, which will give us the same matrices as a result. Now you can multiply any two matrices. I hope you will give your best. Thanks to all of you for your cooperation. Allah Hafiz.